trailer of this video, you might have already noticed that today we are going to create this text portrait effect with POCSS. Without further ado, let's start. Hello and namaste everyone, this is Jitsaru with Coding Design. Welcome to our channel. If you are new here, please be sure to hit that subscribe button. You can see I have image named narrator.png. So in the same folder, let's create the index.html file. Inside the index.html file, if I type exclamatory sign and hit that tab button, you'll get this basic HTML code. So for the title, let's give POCSS portrait effects with animation. Now let's copy this title, and inside the body tag, let's create paragraph tag, and inside that paragraph tag, let's paste this text. Right now I'm using VS Code. In the VS Code, I have installed this extension called Live Server. So if you haven't installed this extension, I would ask you to install this extension. In the index.html file, if I right click and hit that option called Open with Live Server, then it will open it in your default browser. So in the browser, now you can see the output. So it's a very few lines of CSS code. So I am using internal CSS. Just below the title tag, I am creating style tag, and inside the style tag, now let's style the body tag. For the body tag, I am giving the height of 100 VH. And also let's give the background color. For the background color, I am giving this dark blue color. When you save the file in the browser, now you don't need to like refresh your browser. So this is what the advantage of using Live Server. So you can see that scroll bar, but I don't want that scroll bar. So in order to hide that scroll bar, for the body tag, I am giving overflow hidden. And also let's give display flex. Justify content to center, so that would bring your content horizontally center. And also let's give align items to center. Now you can see it is exactly at the center of your browser. So now let's style this paragraph tag. For the paragraph tag, let's give the height of 80 VH. And also I want to give the background image this narrator.png image. So for the background, I'm giving the URL. In the URL, let's keep that narrator.png image. So if I save in the browser, now you can see, but we're not getting the proper size of the image. So for that, I'm giving background size of 60%. If I save, now you can see image is repeating. I'm using the background shorthand property. So for the background property, if I give the no repeat, then you can see the single image. Now I want to change the position of that image. If I give the background position 50%, then you can see it is taken exactly at the center of the paragraph tag. So now let's use the new CSS background clip property. This property is new property, so this property may not be supported by all the old versions of browsers. So for that, I am using the prefix webkit background clip, and for the value, let's give text. So now if I save, now that image is gone. Okay, so in order to get that image back, I need to give more text in the paragraph tag. So inside the paragraph tag, let's remove that title and let's give the dummy text. So for that, I'm writing lorem 4500. So this is the MET abbreviation. So I have already created the separate video on this topic. So at the top right hand corner, you can check it out in the iCard, as well as I'll give the video's link in the description below. You can check it out. 4500 means I'll be generating 4500 words. Okay, if I hit tab button, then you'll get this huge long dummy paragraph. Now you can see in the browser that image. Okay, but in the browser you can see that text, but I want to hide that text. So for that, I'm using another CSS new property called text field color. So I'm using webkit prefix for that text field color, and let's give color value the same color that I have used for the body tag, so that dark blue color. So let's copy and let's paste it there. So for the last two digit, I am giving the 00, so that is the alpha value that controls the transparency of that color. So if you can see in the color picker, that controls the transparency of that color. Okay, so yeah, if I save, you can see the text is hidden, but still that text is there. This is what I want, but you can see text are overflowing. So for the paragraph tag, let's keep overflow hidden. Okay, now you can see overflowing text are hidden. Now let's give the font. For the font width, let's give 100. For the font size, I'm giving 0.5 rem. And for the font family, let's give sans serif. So if I save and let's take it to the full screen, now you can see amazing text portrait effect. I think it's looking really good, but I want to add more animations. So for the paragraph tag, let's give the animation. First of all, I'm giving the animation name. For the animation name, I'm giving reveal. For the animation duration, I'm giving 5 seconds. And for the timing function, let's give is in and out. Okay, so now let's give the keyframe. For the keyframes, first of all, let's write add keyframes. Let's give the animation name reveal. Now for the 0%, I want to give that background size. I want to give background size of that 60%. Let's select this code and let's duplicate it. Instead of that 0%, let's give 50%. So at the 50%, let's change that background size to 100%. So in the browser now, you can see some kind of zoom in effect. Okay, now for the paragraph tag, let's give another CSS property, line height. So for the line height, I'm giving 0.4 rem. And also let's duplicate this code and let's take it to the 0%, and also let's take it to the 50%. So at 0%, I want to give the line height of 20 rem, and at 50%, let's change that 0.4 rem to 10 rem. In the browser now, you can see slowly and gradually image is formed with the help of that paragraphs. So it's looking, I think, really cool. Similarly, let's add some extra feature. So when you hover the paragraph tag, let's give cursor to pointer. And also let's give line height. For the line height, I'm giving 0.6 frame. So in the browser now, you can see when I hover, there is change in the line height, but there is no any transition. So for the paragraph tag, let's give the transition. So for the transition duration, I'm giving 0.5 second. And for the timing function, let's give is in and out. So if I save, and when you hover, look at that. So you can play with these values, okay, and you can create something new, your own effect. For now, let's play with the font size. So you can see for the font size, we have given there 0.5 rem. So instead of that 0.5 rem, let's change it to 8 rem. And for the animation at 0%, let's give the font size. For the font size, I am giving 0.5 rem. And in the browser, now you can see, look at that. So now let's duplicate this code and let's take it to the 50%. So at the 50%, let's change this font size 0.5 rem to 1 rem. So in the browser, you can see some kind of cool animation. So when you hover, I want to change that background size as well. Okay, so for that, let's duplicate this code and let's take it to the paragraph hover. So for the background size, instead of that 100%, let's give 70%. Now in the browser, you can see some kind of cool animation. And when you hover, you can see some kind of zoom in effect. Similarly, I want to change that font size when you hover the paragraph tag. So let's duplicate that code and let's take it to the hover state. So now instead of that 1 rem, let's change it to 6 rem. So if I save, and in the browser now you can see same animation, and when you hover, you'll get the totally different effect, you know. So now instead of that 100, if I give 800 font width, if I save, and in the browser, you can see same animation, and when you hover the image, now you can see some kind of, you know, like explosion particles, you know, some kind of particles that they are appearing. So you can play with the CSS property related to text, something like font size, font width, line height, word spacing, letter spacing, you know, so many things. So you can play with those value and you can create something new, cool, you know, effects. So yeah, let me know in the comment box, like, what did you try it and what did you love the best? Okay, so that's all for today. Thank you so much for watching this video. If you did learn something, smash that like button. If you have any kind of queries, let me know in the comment box. Share this video if you think someone needs it. And also, if you haven't already yet, hit that subscribe button and also the notification bell icon. Remember, there is always more to learn. So keep learning.